Slower inserting or faster is better? Lower temperature or high temperature? Does it make any difference? Let's find out.
Hello, welcome back. I already did several videos about threaded inserts. The last one, I think it is quite important. I tested different sizes, but somehow that video stuck on quite low number of the views. Maybe most of you think that the size doesn't matter. That's right, the size is important. Watch that video. And in this video, I want to test if different inserting speed or set temperature has effect to this connection between a brass threaded insert and 3D printed plastic. And usually for this, I'm using this cheap soldering iron. It is set to some temperature, but which temperature, I'm not sure. And in this video, I want to use this tool. This box is sent to me by the Mintion company. This is not a sponsored video, there is no additional payment. Actually, the whole video is still sponsored by Polymaker, who became a channel sponsor. They asked me for the review video, but I told them that I have a project in progress where I can use this tool and I can present it here. I wanted to do some DIY machine anyway to measure accurately the different speeds, but in this case I will use this one. Additionally, it is digital, so I can set the temperature more accurately, unlike with this cheap soldering iron. In most cases, I could solve everything with this cheap tool. But even if I am quite experienced in this, definitely in last project I could use something like this. A student asked me if he can repair this push button because it was broken. So in our first design, that middle part was quite weak because of weaker layer adhesion. And in second version, we decided to use a threaded insert and MC metallic bolt inside. It will be much stronger. But here it was very important that metallic bolt to have 90 degree angle with that flat surface. And for this we have to insert these threaded inserts quite accurately. Usually I solve this by inserting almost completely in, and then I press if it's a flat surface. But in this case I don't have enough space because the threaded insert is inside the hole.
Just quickly let's check what is in the package.
Before you install the Z-axis, don't forget to insert this retractable mechanism. The instructions are not so clear, but there is a nice video on the YouTube channel.
Now let's tighten the X-setting nut.
Very useful. In user manual, we can see the recommended print temperatures for different materials.
But I don't know, usually I go with higher temperatures. But I will test exactly this.
With box, it arrives with 30 pieces of this M3 threaded inserts. Let me check the dimensions. The length is 4 mm, the outer diameter 5. But for me, this diameter is important too, because it goes to the 3D printed hole, and it's 3.97 in this case. I'm just curious, is it compatible with my old soldering iron? If it would be more accurate, then I could use this one too. In the meantime, I got some replacement parts, because in mass production this is injection molded and not 3D printed, which you saw in my unboxing, but the functionality is basically the same.
This hole is 0.3 mm bigger than the diameter of the brass insert, so I know it will be tight fit, and the cylindrical part is here just to have this test object centered in my test equipment. Let's see the materials I will use here. Creality Hyper PLA. At this point I'm not sure how many objects I need. They are all printed with 5 walls and 50% infill.
PETG test objects are printed on any cubic Cobra S1. Polymaker Polylite ABS, and they are printed also on any cubic printer. In the first part of the experiment I am testing different speeds, and I will set the temperature to 240 degrees Celsius for all three types of the materials. I printed this object. And actually I cannot really manipulate the speed, but the force, which I use for pressing in. And first I will try with this 0.5 kg weight, so it will press down very slowly, the soldering iron. And later, I'm not sure at this moment properly, it will be 2.5 kg, which will be extremely fast inserting. And I measure in practice, usually I'm using my force, which is approximately 1.25 kg.
But for noticeable difference in effect, I'm using this big difference in the loads. It is very important, I will follow the inserting, and when it is almost completely in, I will stop the inserting and I will press it with this flat surface, because the depth of the insert may also have the effect of the strength. 240 degrees. This is real time speed, I will not speed up this part so you can see approximately the inserting speed. Okay, now it's almost completely in, and I'm pressing it. And now it is flat with the surface. From PLA I have 3 with slow inserting, and now 3 with fast inserting. I hope it will not be too fast and I can stop on time. Oh, this is very fast. Okay. Only from the PLA I will have a 3-3 test objects. This is now the PETG slow inserting. I think this was way too slow. And now fast inserting. And I think this is way too fast. ABS slow inserting. And now ABS fast inserting. Definitely, I think the sweet spot is somewhere between 1 or 1, in this case 1.25 kilograms, I will use in my next part, where I will manipulate different temperatures, and the speed, or in this case the force, will be constant. I was thinking a lot which temperatures to use, but I am going closer to the edges of recommended temperatures. For PLA 190-240, PETG between 200-240, and for the ABS between 220 and 260 degrees Celsius. And this is more important information for me, so I will have more test objects. And with this I used almost all brass inserts I got in the package. Temperature is set to 190 degrees Celsius, and of course already mentioned, load will be 1.25 kilograms. PLA 240 degrees Celsius. PETG 200 degrees Celsius, and I have 2 from this temperature. PETG 240 degrees Celsius. And now ABS 220 degrees Celsius. ABS on 260 degrees Celsius. Of course I will wait until it heats up. But it heats up very quickly. That's it. So this is the first group with variated speed, and this is the second group, so everything is prepared. I can start with the testing, measuring the pulling out force in kilograms. First I want to show you something, because this was new to me. This is my old soldering iron, and this I made from the steel. Yes, not so good material for this, but I could clearly see where the insert ends and starts the soldering iron, so very easily I can stop on time to press it with the flat surface. With a tool made from the brass
It is hard to see where it ends when the insert starts, so with this I have to be more careful to stop on the time. Maybe from the copper it would be better, or maybe somehow to color this surface.
Let's start with testing. This is with Variating inserting speed or pressing in load. Even now it is quite obvious to me that fast inserting is not good. Let's check the results and then we will move to the different temperatures. On this graph, we can see that the slow inserting resulted approximately 20% stronger parts compared to the fast inserting. But I think in most cases this slow was way too slow and sometimes the fast was way too fast. But overall I think this difference is not big. We cannot go really wrong with going too fast or too slow. And now let's see the effect of variating the inserting temperature. This is how they look like now, and if I would cut off this middle part, then probably I could even reuse them. As expected, high temperature resulted stronger connection, but I thought that the difference will be much bigger. This means just set some temperature in the recommended temperature range, don't go too fast and you will be fine. Just one more graph. With the variation of temperature experiment for the PLA and PETG, I have a 240 degrees Celsius. So I can compare the 1.25 kg inserting load to, and we can see that it is somewhere between the two.
Well, this means I will not change my inserting method. This means I will set the temperature to 240 degrees Celsius, well, maybe for the ABS or nylon a little bit higher, and then I will push it with my hand to have that inserting time between 5 to 10 seconds, and I know it will be fine. And now let's try to clean these threaded inserts, because I just hate to have unnecessary waste. And if you'd like to support this kind of work, please like or subscribe to my channel, but donations are very welcome too. If you pay attention, usually this size of the channel get much higher number of the views. I'm not sure why, but this YouTube algorithm drives me crazy. But huge thanks to all my Patreon supporters, because basically they keep this channel alive and they are supporting me in this kind of works too. To all you others, thank you for watching this video until the end, and happy printing and inserting.